Hello and welcome to E4M Live from Cannes on a very windy day. I have with me today Anushree Ghosh. She's with ITC, and Anushree was this year part of the media jury. And we just want to get insights from Anushree on how the experience has been. Anushree, welcome to E4M.
Thank you very much.
Anushree, this is your third time at Cannes. So how is, what are the changes that you've seen over the years that you've been coming here?
I think, I've looked at it as someone who has entered, my work in the past. I've looked at it as a brand owner who's kind of thought about really telling a story which kind of encapsulates the rigor that goes behind, telling or creating a heady case which is relevant for Cannes. And I'm now looked at entries as a juror. I've seen a lot of shift in terms of the role of data and finding stories within data. So it's not necessarily just hardworking left brain data. It's essentially finding storytelling opportunities, within reams of data. And I think that's also happening because the media landscape is shifting. Its brands are kind of becoming more and more consumer centric, I'm guessing, which enables to kind of really spot those opportunities, with consumer journeys, and hence tell stories which are really relevant, keeping the consumer and the brand at the center. So I think that's what I have seen, from pure play, just beautiful storytelling, to data-driven storytelling, and storytelling that goes forward in demonstrating it, to consumers. I think that's the shift that I have seen over the years.
What was the experience of being on the jury?
So I've been in the creative data jury, and it's they call it slightly early days, although it's been quite a few years now. The jury was a very, very diverse set of very, very passionate folks, and it ranged from marketers like me to strategic planners to creative folks and analytics folks. So imagine the heady combination of left and right brain. I think it was a wonderful experience. We felt, I think there were moments of dissent a little bit, but we all kind of unified ourselves, our thinking around great creative work. So my category essentially was at the intersection of creative and data, and how data propels creative storytelling. So I think we were all united by the cause of great work, great advertising, great storytelling. So I think that's pretty much that was pretty much my experience with the jury.
Any particular campaign that stood out for you?
Oh, well, a few of them, which we've kind of gone ahead and shortlisted, and they'll also go ahead and win. So I think the kind of work that really, really stood out for us is, and I think one of the focus points of the jury essentially was to kind of cut through a lot of, circumlocuted conversation around data and cut through to the idea.
Okay.
Spot the idea from reams of data. I think that was one of the things that we took upon ourselves as the jury. A couple of pieces of work that really, really stood out for me, and it's a MasterCard campaign. You will see that it's called Room for Everyone. I think one thing that it does beautifully is that it kind of taps into the socio-cultural, economic stories of the geography that it actually comes from, and how it beautifully kind of how it beautifully kind of surrounds itself, where the brand pretty much sits in the center. In fact, the brand and the data that it owns actually would have been the key constituents in arriving at the opportunities that came about and which kind of brought this campaign out. So it's MasterCard's Room for Everyone. The other one is from back home. I absolutely love Tough Finder by Gatorade. I think we've seen that. You'll see it in multiple categories, and it's one of one of our hero campaigns that we have really, really nurtured and loved throughout our judging process. There are a couple of other campaigns that we absolutely loved, both in the space of disruption, how data can really propel or even kind of really inspire very traditional categories like finance to look at consumers differently. So it's called Gamer Loan. It's by one of the Ecuadorian banks. Banks essentially are very, very close-minded about assets, but it essentially enables access to a completely newer set of audiences, because in Ecuador, there are physical asset ownership between the 18 to 30 year olds is lesser, as opposed to digital goods, which is gaming assets. So I think it's very, very close. These three actually stood out for me quite a bit.
Any learnings that you will take back, so that you can implement it for the...
Absolutely. I think lots of learnings. And I think we as Indians have seen it. We as Indians, it also kind of... The market actually gives us the opportunity to kind of do it. It's always great ideas are never going to go out of fashion. Where do you spot that idea from is where creativity lies. Mm-hmm. So it's not going to be that 30-second film that we have always thought to be the hero piece of communication. It could be that even, but where is it coming from? It's coming from a very strong consumer truth, which is in demonstrated behaviors on digital or physical. How do you really spot those opportunities, bring them alive in the form of an idea which can be extended through digital, physical, omni-channel, commerce, all of it? So I think that's a learning that's always been with us. I think we are well poised to kind of create more of those. I've seen some great Indian work and we are hoping that there is many more to come, many more unique pieces. I think as a market, we are so interesting. As a market, we are, first of all, many of us, so much of diversity, so much of opportunities to find different behaviors and how those could be woven in the form of a story. So I think a lot of those reinforce the learning that we have had in the past as well.
You talked about the Gatorade campaign. What is your sense where India stands, when you've seen all the global campaign, where India stands in terms of creativity, in terms of use of technology, etc.?
I think we are in very good stead. Like I said, it was very important for this jury to cut through a lot of fluff. And one thing that we really spot with many cases, and I think a lot of jurors will say this, is that it's not, you can't really fool us with a lot of data points. It's actually the meat of the matter is the core of the idea. So I think we are in great stead, both from a creative thinking perspective as well as technologically. We tell great stories. We have many stories. We have varied behaviors which can be woven into the stories. So I think we are in great stead. It's a matter of time, and we've seen it. I think India has been doing pretty well in the global stage, and more power to us.
The jury process must have been very strenuous, but have you had time to go around Palais, and have you managed to catch any session which caught your eye? AI is the top point this year. So overall, what's been going on?
I'm just coming out of the father of AI almost, a session from Elon Musk. Really inspiring. He's always so interesting with his perspectives. I caught a bunch of sessions. I caught a lot of marketing sessions as well. But I think this one stands out. I think a lot of people will tell you that this one pretty much was the hero session for Cannes. There are others as well. To me, I think all of it comes together, those brilliant basics around spotting opportunities with consumers and weaving it to a story. If you stay true to that, the source of your consumer insight could be anywhere. How do you give that creative leap and, weave it into a story is where we as marketers and advertising folks, our role essentially kind of gets justified. I think we should continue to do the same and be open-minded about where the idea is actually coming from. I don't think technology will take away the power of original human thinking. And I think that's the advantage, and we should kind of really withhold that advantage and continue original thinking across peers, be it any category.
Thank you so much, Anushree, for your time. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot.